myself, Bharadhar Karat, New Vishal Mahadalaya Madhubani, subject physics, topic astrophysics. We will discuss the article composition of two SHMs. Composition of two SHMs having equal different amplitude, different initial phases, moving along the same path. Suppose that such two linear SHMs having different amplitude A1 and A2. Initial phases alpha 1 and alpha 2. And period capital T is equal to 2 pi are represented by the equation of the displacement x1 is equal to a1 sin omega t plus alpha and x2 equal to a2 sin omega t plus alpha. So these are the two equations of the displacements representing two linear systems. Now suppose that a particle is subjected simultaneously to such two linear systems. Then the resultant displacement of the particle x is given by principle of superposition of this, and according to which the resultant displacement is vector sum of the individual displacement. So resultant displacement x will be equal to a1 sin omega t plus alpha 1 plus a sin omega t plus 1. If we solve this equation, rearranging the term sin omega t plus alpha 1 by using sin a plus b sin a cos b plus cos a sin a, so we have equation x equal to r sin omega t plus delta. And this equation of the resultant motion shows that the resultant motion is also linear. So composition of the two linear SHM is also a linear SHM. Having period omega, which is equal to 2 pi by capital T, or capital T period equal to 2 pi by omega, same as the individual SHMs. However, the amplitude of the resultant SHM, which is represented by the capital R, is given by the equation. R is equal to A1 square plus A2 square plus twice A1 A2 cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2. And the initial phase delta of the resultant SHM is given by delta equal to tan inverse of A1 sin alpha 1 plus A2 sin alpha divided by A1 cos alpha 1 plus A2 cos alpha. So this is the equation for the amplitude of the resultant SHM and initial phase of the resultant SHM. The amplitude of the resultant SHM in different conditions can be handled as, say, we if you consider special cases 1 or first case as, suppose alpha 1 equal to alpha, that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2 in G. So cos alpha 1 minus alpha 2 equal to 1. The equation becomes R equal to square root of A1 square plus A2 square plus twice A1 A2. That is R equal to A1 square. If we have this A1 plus A2 bracket square taking square root of this r equal to a over plus c2, and if a1 equal to a2, then r is twice. The second case is if alpha 1 minus alpha has a phase difference of pi, then cos alpha 1 minus alpha 2 will be chi. And the equation for the resultant displacement, capital R, will be a1 square plus a2 square plus twice a1 a2 into chi. That is square root of a1 square plus a2 square. One side, if a1 equal to a2, then a square plus a square, that is twice a square, or root 2 times a1 equal to a2 equal to say a. Then this is the equation. If alpha 1 minus alpha 2 is equal to pi, then this becomes minus. Resultant amplitude for the third case will be a1 square plus a2 square plus twice a1 a2 into minus 1, that is a1 square plus a2 square minus twice a1. That is a1 minus a2 bracket square, with the assumption a1 is greater than a. So resultant amplitude r is equal to a1 difference. If a1 is greater, this is a1 minus a2. If a2 is greater, then this equation is a2 minus a1. And if a1 is equal to a2, then r will be. So these are the different cases for the resultant. In general, we should remember that the composition of the two linear systems is also with amplitude capital R is equal to square root of a1 square plus a2 square plus twice a1 a2 into cos of alpha 1 minus alpha, and initial phase delta equal to tan inverse of a1 sin alpha 1 plus a2 sin alpha 2 divided by a1 cos alpha 1 minus a2 cos alpha. The different cases are as discussed for the different phase differences of the two systems.